as we celebrate a new class to be inducted to the Baseball Hall of Fame and look ahead to next year, one name always seems to pop up. Pete Rose, who is in Cooperstown this weekend. The Major League's all-time leader in hits is still under a ban dating back 20 years for his past gambling transgressions, including those in which he played and managed. But many people feel that Charlie Hustle has done his time and that those transgressions were nothing compared to the guys in the steroid era. Will he ever get in? Well, that remains to be seen. But if he did, Rose says it would be a dream come true.
You know, anybody like to be a Hall of Fame. It'd be the biggest thing that ever happened to anybody, and I'm in the same boat as everybody else. And if it ever happens, I'll be the happiest guy in the world. If it doesn't happen, I have nobody to blame but myself. I'm the one that made the mistake, and I'm not going to sit here and complain about this guy or that guy because, you know, I'm, up till now, I'm the reason that I'm not here. And it's just one of those things that I wish I could reverse it, but unfortunately, I can't.
Another guy who a lot of folks would love to see in the hall is Jim Cott, a former teammate of Bly Levins on the Twins, who was also in the Coop this weekend and talked about his first ever visit half a century ago.
I went to college with some kids from Herkimer College, from Herkimer, New York, back in the Midwest. So in 1956, as a college freshman, I came here. I have a picture on my desk of my dad coming to Lefty Groves induction in 47. This is probably my 12th induction. And as I told Commissioner Selig last night, every player, it almost ought to be mandatory that they come here and see the village and go through the Hall of Fame.